Hello everyone, happy Friday. I hope you've all had a wonderful week full of fantastic learning and are looking forward to a restful weekend. Today, it's the 20th of November and this is also World Children's Day. It's a day that's celebrated internationally, which means that it is something that happens all around the world. So this is celebrated globally. Some countries celebrate it on different days of the year, but it is still a special day to be recognised. Now, World Children's Day is celebrated each year to encourage international togetherness, to raise awareness among children worldwide, and to improve children's welfare. That means to make you healthier and happier. The day also celebrates you, as children, having rights, and that means that you and every human being must be treated with equality, respect, and dignity, because you are all unique and special. But enough of my voice, let us listen to Nabila's story. She's a refugee, which means that she has been forced to leave her country of birth in order to escape something terrible in her country, like war. Here is how World Children's Day has helped her and why she believes it is important.
We left Syria and we went to Istanbul, from Istanbul to Edinburgh and from Edinburgh to Glasgow. When I got to the UK, I was happy because I'm in a safe place. When I was in Syria, the weather were like so sunny in the summer. It was cold in the winter, but it's still sunny in the summer. But when I came here, I realised that it's cold all the time. I achieved lots of awards during school in the UK. Last year I got the best pupil of the school, of the whole school, not just my year. And I got a medal for that, a gold medal. I'm taking part in Right Respecting School. I'm participating in three groups. We're trying our best to give every child their rights. And if any child does not know that they've got rights, we tell them. By getting ideas from the pupils, we can make our school better for everybody. We done a racism day, which show racism the red card, where everyone in the school wear red. When I came here, I felt that I can do everything, I can do whatever I like to. I've got rights, so I can go out with friends, go to school, go shopping in the night. I'm not scared because it's fine. But not every refugee child ends up in a safe place with their family like me. There are millions of children on the move fleeing war, poverty and violence in all these countries. Many have lost their family or been separated from them, are missing out on school and need protecting. But it's not hopeless. There is an international agreement called the Convention on the Rights of the Child. Sounds a bit complicated, doesn't it? But it can save lives and bring families together. The agreement gives you the right to special protection and help if you are a refugee. Every child has a right to a good quality education and to be protected from being hurt and mistreated. It gives every child the right to play and rest, and if you live in a different country than your parents do, you have the right to be together in the same place. Almost every country, including the UK, signed up to these rights and dozens more on November 20th, 1989, World Children's Day. No one is better placed to stand up and speak out for children's rights than children, which is why on World Children's Day, we must make our voices heard by governments, in school and in our communities. No matter our religion, no matter our nationality, no matter our colour, we're all the same.
Wow, Nabila has been through a lot in her life already. Imagine what that must feel like to move from your home country to a completely different one where you may speak a different language, you might look different, or even dress differently. How would you feel? But this is where it is important to know that being different makes you special, because we are all unique, and the most important thing to take away from this is that we are all welcome no matter our differences. And that is exactly the message of this story that I'd like to share with you all. I hope you enjoy. All Are Welcome Here by Alexandra Penfold and Suzanne Kaufman. Pencils sharpened in their case, bells are ringing, let's make haste, school's beginning, dreams to chase, all are welcome here. No matter how you start your day, what you wear when you play, or if you come from far away, all are welcome here. In our classroom, safe and sound, fears are lost and hope is found. Raise your hand, we'll go around, all are welcome here. Gather now, let's take part, we'll play music, we'll make art. We'll share stories from the heart, all are welcome here. Time for lunch, what a spread, a dozen different kinds of bread. Pass it around till everyone's fed, all are welcome here. Open doors, rush outside, we will swing, we will slide. We'll have fun side by side, all are welcome here. We're part of a community, our strength is our diversity, a shelter from adversity, all are welcome here. We will learn from each other, special talents we'll uncover, there's a big world to discover, all are welcome here. So much to learn, so much to do, and when the busy day is through, can't wait to come back, start anew, all are welcome here. Head for home, get some rest, and greet tomorrow, ready and fresh. Our time together is the best, all are welcome here. You have a place here. You have a space here. You are all welcome here. What a beautiful story and inspiring message. So let's celebrate some of our different achievements from this week and award some merits. Starting with Year 2's merits, the first goes to Emily P for her excellent effort in English this week. Well done, Emily. And the other merit goes to Yasmin for always being an excellent role model in class. Well done, guys. Moving on to reception, this merit is a joint one and it goes to Grace and Mila for their work on Diwali, specifically recalling the information on the festival and making a great Diwali picture. Well done, Diwali is a wonderful festival. Then we go to Year 6 for these merits and they are going to Sophie for her sustained effort across all subjects. Well done. And the second merit goes to Freddie for his marvellous singing. So fantastic, both of you. Next are the Year 4 merits, and they are going to Cara for being such a studious and conscientious student. Well done. And the second goes to Max for his great contributions to lessons, as he is always ready to share his thoughts with the class. Well done, both of you. Now we're moving on to Year 1, and these merits are going to Marcos for being a fantastic talk partner this week. And the other merit goes to Bella for her passion and enthusiasm when she has been set challenges, so well done both. Next, we're going to Year 3, and they go to Lila for her fantastic focus on participation in your Stone Age Day. And the second goes to Joshua for fantastic improvements in his reading and comprehension. Well done, and I hope you enjoyed that Stone Age Day. Now, I think I've kept my Year 5s in suspense long enough, so these merits are going to Abel for positive behaviour this week and for improving in his times tables. Keep it up. And finally, the second merit goes to Raya May for showing excellent effort in her homework and for always taking great care in her presentation of work. Well done. Well done, everybody. And now, the bit you've all been waiting for, the house points. So this week, 1 point has been awarded to the parrots. Well done. 2 points have been awarded to the dolphins. 3 points goes to the wildcats, which means 4 points goes to the alligators. Well done. Overall, in 4th place are the parrots with 19 points. In 3rd place are the dolphins with 25. In 2nd place are the Wildcats with 29, which means that Alligators are in first place with 31 points. So well done, Alligators. To end today's assembly, I'm going to play a favourite song of ours that I think really encourages us to be happy with how unique we all are. Have a wonderful weekend, everyone.
Do you ever feel like a plastic bag drifting through the wind, wanting to start again? Do you ever feel this so paper thin, like a house of cards, one blow from caving in? Do you ever feel already buried deep, 6 feet under screens and no one seems to hear a thing? Do you know that there's still a chance for you, 'cause there's a spark in you, you just gotta ignite the light and let it shine just on the night, like the 4th of July. 'Cause baby you're a firework, come on show 'em what you're worth, make 'em go as you shoot across the sky. Your